Is someone there? Is someone there?
You don't have a chance! You can't hide from me! Oh well. Must have run off.
Worthless mercenaries. I didn't think Maven or Mercer would allow me to get away with this, but I had little choice. I didn't think Maven or Mercer would allow me to get away with this, but I had little choice. No! I'm not about to let you ruin everything I've worked so hard for. Ah!
Nothing here after all.
Hello? Who's there? What was that? Someone there.
Thank you. Need a ride? Where do you want to go?
Climb and back, and we'll be off.
I can't wait here forever.
Being old's not so bad. I'm too old to work, but that don't make me too old to drink.
Fancy yourself an alchemist, hmm? Never could get the hang of that.
Not supposed to be in here. I'm not gonna warn you again. Get out, or I'll call the guards! You...
Citizen?
can't a woman get a moment to herself? Leave me.
Youngest bard at the Bard's College, at your service.
Welcome to the Bard's College. I'm the headmaster here. How may I help you? May song speed you along.
Hello, yes. I'm the Dean of History.
Remember, being a bard isn't just about the music. Explosion?
Welcome to Solitude. It is my personal mission to ensure that the Bard's College preserves the great deeds of the past in both poetry and song. Always a pleasure to meet a prospective bard. You should be aware that many apply, but we accept very few people. When possible, we ask applicants to perform tasks the college needs completed. In this case, I do have a task befitting an aspiring bard. Elisif has forbidden the burning of King Olaf, a festival put on by the Bard's College. We need to change her mind. To convince her, I want to read King Olaf's verse, a part of the Poetic Edda, the living history of Skyrim. Unfortunately, the verse was lost long ago. Yes, according to Giraud, our history's keeper, the portion of the Edda dealing with King Olaf might still exist in Dead Man's Respite. I need you to retrieve the poem. I think Giraud here would give you the best explanation of both it and the history of King Olaf's verse. You should speak to him about it. As you may be aware, Elisif's husband, High King Torig, was recently killed. Elisif mourns her husband deeply, and she feels that a festival that burns a king in effigy is distasteful. I tried to convince her the festival is many centuries old and celebrates solitude, but I need proof. I believe King Olaf's verse will provide that proof. Not much, to be honest. Their return was a shock to us all. Gerard Germain has some tomes about them in the library, if you're interested. Not much. But as a bard, I find the whole affair depressing. There are no heroes in this war, no winners to be had, and no real conclusion. If you want something a bard can dig into, look to the dragons. 1,000 years from now, Skyrim will have changed rulers dozens of times. But the return of the dragons, that story is once in an era. I wish you luck in finding the verse.
Good evening. I'm Pantia Atia, the master vocalist. It's been my honor to perform at the Blue Palace on many occasions. His late lordship was quite the admirer.
I'm Dean of Lute at the Bard's College, and no, I don't give private lessons. It takes two things to be a good teacher. The first is patience. The second is a firm wooden stick for rapping knuckles.
Youngest bard at the Bard's College, at your service.
Lady Atia says my voice is second only to hers, but she's selling me short.
Meals are served to bards at designated times. Find an inn if you want to make requests.
You're new here, right? Welcome to the Bard's College. It's like a musical museum.
I wish only to graduate and enroll with the Legion. My drums will lead our troops to victory. And why wouldn't I be? We sing tales of kings, queens, and their politics, 'tis true. But do you know who really makes history? The person who writes it. Farewell, stranger.
Lady Atia says my voice is second only to hers, but she's selling me short.
Be sure to watch your finger positions, especially during the transitions.
Youngest bard at the Bard's College, at your service.
Ataf, please play back that piece for me.
Good to meet a prospective bard. He's sending you after King Olaf's verse, then. That's good. We shouldn't leave it lying around now that I've figured out where it is. The verse was Svaknir's contribution to the poetic Edda, the living history of Skyrim. Each bard adds to the Edda in his or her time. And a very ancient one. The verse criticized the reigning King Olaf. He was so incensed the bard was put to death and all the copies burned. At least, that's what we thought until I translated some ancient texts a year or so ago. We now believe King Olaf buried the truth with the bard. If I'm right, Svaknir and King Olaf's verse lie in Dead Men's Respite, along with the burial chamber of King Olaf himself.
Your job to deliver these songs, to excite the crowds, draw them
in. Be careful. You might find more than just King Olaf's verse in Dead Man's Respite.
You're not supposed to be here.
These vampires are becoming a real menace.
Need a ride? Where do you want to go?
Climb and back, and we'll be off.
You ready to go yet? You ever met one of them cats?
Khajiit, I think they called themselves.
I hear there's...
Pull up a seat. Ever couldn't have done it better myself. Here's your coin. Could I give you a little tip? Take every job you can get.
Out with it.
Or else you'll end
amazing what people leave laying around for us to take, isn't it? Come on, take another job so we can both make some money.
Word on the street is Golden Glow's been hit. Good job, lad. Let me take a look at what you found.
Arengarth sold Golden Glow? What's that idiot thinking?
He has no idea the extent of Maven's fury when she's been cut out of a deal. But I'm certain he'll find out. If only the parchment had the buyer's name instead of this odd symbol. Any idea what that might be? Blast. Well... I'll check my sources and speak to Mercer. But for now, you're off to speak to Maven Blackbriar. She asked for you by name. No. Nothing like that. You're calling on her for business. That's between you and Maven, and I prefer to keep it that way. Don't worry about it. Maven's business dealings usually involve quite a bit of gold for her people. Of course, your pay. You're smart as a whiplot. Keep doing right by us, and there's plenty more where that came from. Until next we meet, lad.
Still have quite a good bit of need some gold. I may have some work for you. Well, well. I was looking for this little beauty. If you happen across any other unusual trinkets like this, be sure to bring them to me. I promise it'll be worth the effort. There you go. This should cover it. There's plenty more work for the likes of you.
So, you're Brynjolf's new protege, eh? Don't look like much to me.
So you're the one. You don't look so impressive. You're a firebrand, aren't you? It's about time Brynjolf sent me someone with business sense. I was beginning to think he was running some sort of beggar's guild over there. Faith. I don't have faith in anyone. All I care about is cause and effect. Did the job get done, and was it done correctly? There's no gray area. Head to the Bannered Mare in Whiterun and look for Malus Machius. He'll fill you in on all the details. Some layabout named Sabjorn. Been a thorn in my side for the last few years now. Not a day goes by that I don't regret letting Sabjorn get as far as he did. In only a few short years, he's taken that bile he calls mead to market and a chunk of my profits with it. I can't imagine where he found the gold to take it to market so quickly. Exactly. With Sabjorn in prison, his meadery will be forced to close. Then I swoop in and take over the place. No more competition. The Golden Glow estate job has undoubtedly interrupted the supply of honey I need to make my mead. Sabjorn could use this interruption to his advantage and collect a larger share of the market. I can't have that. One more time, in case I wasn't clear. You butcher this job, and you will be sorry. Shouldn't you be on your way to Whiterun?
You have... Do you have any idea? Huh? So you're an alchemist, then? Yes, yes, goodbye.
Thank you.
Do you have any idea how busy I am? Take a look. Yes, yes, goodbye.
Greetings, honored friend. Could I interest you in some fine jewelry?
Ain't no doubt about it. The Thieves Guild is back, and they've got Riften in their grip.
What do you need, my friend? I have to remember, ward first, then summon.
The Imperials think we need their loss.
Try to hide it all you want. I know you're in the Thieves' Guild, and so do the other guards.
Welcome to Mistvale Keep. I'm Jarl Layla's steward, Anuriel. The house I mentioned earlier is still available if you want to buy it. Wonderful. Here is the key to your new home. You're welcome in Riften. As Riften's steward, I'm afraid I can provide only... I'll be glad to help you. There are many ways to improve your home, provided you have the coin. And of course, don't forget to consult your home decorating guide for descriptions of the decorations you can buy. Now, what would you like to purchase? Very well. I'll make the arrangements. The next time you visit your house, your new furnishings will be in place. Is there anything else you'd like to purchase?
Staying safe, I hope?
As long as you continue to obey our laws.
Greetings, honored friend. See for yourself. Safe travels, Landstrider.
There's an apothecary in town, yeah. But it's down on the lower walkway, so stay sharp if you go down there.
Welcome to the Pond Prawn. Come on in, take a look around. Welcome to the Pond Prawn. Trinkets, odds and ends, that sort of thing. Some may call this junk. Me? I call them treasures.
Need a drink? You go to the B and Bob. Stay out of the Ragged Flagon. Stay out of the Red Wing.
You're someone who can get things done. Welcome to Riften, traveler. I hope the road fared well for you. Then allow me to officially welcome you to Riften. You'll make a fine addition to our city. All that remains now is to bestow the title upon you. I should be the one thanking you. You've solved more problems in the short time you've been here than anyone in my court has their entire careers. You've been a beacon of hope in these dark times for my people, and I will never forget it. Therefore, by my authority as Jarl, I pronounce you Thane of Riften, and award you all the benefits befitting your station. Congratulations. Good journey to you.
Excuse my disorganization. I had you figured for a mage. I think you'll appreciate this. I have to remember. Ward first, then summon.
Staying safe, I hope.